Well, what can I say? Welcome to Larford Lakes. I'm on the famous specimen lake here. It's a lake that I fish many, many times, not so much nowadays. And believe me, it is absolutely bitterly cold. If you look over there, there's actually seagulls that are actually standing on top of the ice. And as you know, Larford Specimen Lake is a big lake and it's half frozen. Now, this is going to be a proper hard day's fishing, but believe you me, on the right day on a lake like this, where the water's gone a little bit clearer, it's really, really cold, you can have a fantastic day's fishing. And today is all going to be about winter feeder fishing. I know it's going to be tough, you know, but that's what you go fishing for. You know, the nice days when you're getting one every chuck. I don't know what I'm going to catch. So the first thing I'm going to do, which is going to be mega, mega important, is to mix the ground bait up. And I'll tell you exactly what's going through my mind and what ground bait we're going to do in. So the first thing I'm going to do, I'm going to get my box out on a peg that I'm going to choose somewhere along here and mix the ground bait up. Well, as I always say when we go fishing, you know, I've plunked my rod down, I've plunked my box down, got a few bits made up, but I want to do my ground bait. Because as you can probably tell, it's been really cold. We're at Larford Lakes, we're on the specimen lake, and we all know when the conditions go like this, on a big lake like this, it can be really, really tough. Well, I'm sure we're still going to catch some fish. Now, getting to the peg, I've looked at the colour of the water, the lake has lost a lot of colour. So that's going to make a big difference in what ground bait I'm going to use. But my favourite ground bait, or my favourite sort of base mix, if you like, has to be F1 Dark Sweet. It's just one of them ground baits. I know we all use it, you know, summer or winter. It's a fantastic bait for when you want to catch skimmers and roach and fish like that. Now, I've got a little bit left. I've got about enough for our session today. It's probably just about a quarter of a bag because I have been using it, you know, week in, week out recently. So I'm going to stick that in my bucket like that, finish that bag off. Now, another ground bait I fell in love with over the winter and probably last summer was Pro Thatcher's Green. We always needed a green ground bait in the range, and that's what we done last year, and I've just fell in love with it. I think it's absolutely brilliant when you're fishing in the winter, the water's lost its colour, you want a dark mix, and I'm going to put Pro Thatcher's Green in. So not a lot again, probably about a quarter of a bag, a little bit less than the dark F1, but whether I was on the pole or the feeder, I want to try and create a little bit of activity. If I was to put the green Thatcher's and the F1 Dark, mix that up now and put it in the edge and watch it, you'd probably have a little bit of oil coming off of it, but there wouldn't be any particles. And with the conditions as they are, somewhat I've been doing recently, not just on the feeder and the pole, is mixing some sort of crumb-based ground bait in. And my mix today, and you can probably see, I've opened all these bags up, like most of them are after, because I've been using them, So Natural Black Roach. It's got a lot of hemp in it, a tiny little bit of coriander, so it's a little bit of smell, a bit of activity. And looking at the conditions today, I think this could make a lot more bites in the peg. You know, you might get some roach going early and then catch some skimmers. I don't know, but that's what's going through my head. I've been using it recently where I've been going to a lake where skimmers and roach, or you know, you've got to catch both. And believe you me, putting this in has made a huge difference. There's probably half a bag there. I'm not going to put as much in as that. About a quarter of a bag again. So I'm going to whisk that round now dry. Like that. Make sure it's all everything mixed together. Now, if I was fishing the pole today as well, I'd obviously mix a lot more ground bait up because I'd probably put, even though we are fishing in real tough conditions, I would still want to put like 3 or 4 balls in on the pole and probably be loose feeding maggots. But we're not. It's about feeder fishing today. So I'm going to put a bit of water with that a minute. Not a lot. So I'm going to leave that. That's gone a bit claggy at the moment, but that will dry out, obviously, when the water goes in. That's like wet and claggy. Now, what I'm going to do, I'll actually talk about the finished mix when we get fishing. But all I will do now is carry on setting up, come back to this, adjust it with a little bit more water. Obviously, if you can get a whisk, use a whisk. It makes a huge difference, you know, not just to your hands in real cold weather like we're fishing today, but it makes the mix absolutely perfect. But one little tip that I do during the winter is stick it through. I think that's a 3 mil riddle. Honestly, it makes a huge difference to the end of the mix. So what I would do is mix this up, get it how I want it, and stick it through there, not just once, but twice. I know people say, oh, why do you do that? But honestly, if you do it for a fine riddle like that, the end result is so much different. It just makes it like, it just looks absolutely perfect. It feels perfect. And through the feeder today, I'm not going to be fishing with a wet ground bait. It's going to be dry. If I need to adjust it, I'll adjust it on my tray. But like I said, I will talk about the finished mix when we get going. Well, this is now my third bream. One thing I've noticed straight away, it's taken a long time to get a bite, probably 45 minutes, which, to be honest, with the conditions, I didn't expect nothing else. And chucking those just half a dozen feeder falls out at the start with not a lot in it, really. I didn't want to put a lot of particles in at the start. I wanted to sort of feel my way into it because it's important some days. But they're all quality fish. The ones I've had, this is another fish probably getting on for £2. And the bites are really aggressive. If you think how cold the water must be, he's a good £2er, that one. But chucking those 6 feeder falls in at the start, emptying a couple on the way down, just to make a bit of a cloud. And I can actually, because it's really flat con, which is really unusual for a Larford on the Specy Lake, you know, normally you don't get conditions like this very often. With that bit of black roach I put in, you can actually see your like little bits of oil come off the ground bait and stuff. That's another like Larford beauty, that. I mean, that's probably the smallest one that I've had out of the three. So it looks like we're gonna have a real nice session now. But it is, and like I've always said in a lot of my videos in the winter, probably with carp and silvers, you know, is getting that first bite, that first indication. And then some days, you know, you might have to wait 15 minutes, you might have to wait 2 hours. But when you start catching, there's nothing better. Just a maggot, a dead maggot, single dead maggot. It's one of my best favourite baits. You're probably all sick about hearing it on my Facebook page. But maggot and fluoro pinky, it don't get better. But what I have started doing is putting probably 20 or 30 fluoro pinkies in. Because I was sat there for like, probably like I said, like 40 minutes, nothing happened. And I thought, well, I'll just start putting some pinkies in. Wherever that was, you know, whether that's made a difference, I'm not sure, but it certainly hasn't helped, if you like. Little baby feeder, probably fishing about 30 metres, which I think is a nice distance on a big lake like this. I think a lot of people, when they come here carp fishing, they sort of catapult pellets there, and you think that's probably where the bream want to sit. 11-foot SL Supera, I mean, it don't get better. Got that 012 absolute braid on, and I've got me little 8-pound sinking feeder mono with the actual rig on, which I can run you through that in a little bit. But just sticking with a little feeder. One thing I'm gonna get out of is my stopwatch, because now I've had my first bite. I've not left it out there. I've started fishing and left it out there probably 8 or 9 minutes, something like that. I'm not just sitting there and sitting there and sitting there. There will be a time, you know, when you're fishing in conditions like I am today, there does become a time when you have just got to sit there, whether you're carp fishing or bream fishing, you know, it's obvious that you've not had a bite. But that first hour, even though I've only just had 6 casts with a feeder at the start to get a bit of bait in, I don't just sit there for like 20 minutes. You need to try and make something happen. The time of me sitting there for like just waiting for a bite out of the blue would probably be after sort of 2 hours. You know, that's the sort of days when you're sort of keeping your fingers crossed just that you get a few bites. But That last 20 minutes, I've had 3 bites, all good fish. I had a liner as well. So I'm hoping now that they'll come into me peg. I'm not bothered about sitting there for 10 minutes. You know what I mean? If they're £2 to £3 a piece, I'm like, thanks for coming. So I'm just getting me braid down. I'm not holding me rod. I've got it in me rest there. So I can be nice and patient. You know, at the moment, it's not that sort of fishing. I'm not getting loads of bites. If it changes, then I'll have the rod on me knee, fishing, you know, like that. Obviously in and out a lot more. It ain't like that at the moment. I'm going to get my stopwatch out. Even though we are bream fishing or skimmer fishing, you might just be able to learn something from that. You know, not just about when you're getting your bites, but don't leave your feeder in as long, you know, too long. Because I have had one little liner as well, and you think, oh yeah, it did go round though about 2 minutes later. I just want to take it nice and easy, not put too much through the feeder, use the ground bait to get the fish in your peg, and then try and work out if I need to put a lot of particles in to actually get the fish feeding. But it's really nice. I mean, like I said, nice soft rod, you know, braid. You're allowed to use braid at Larford on your silverfish fishing, which is really, really nice. And I'm just sitting there. I've not even really got a bend in the rod. It's literally just sat there and you can just see the braid. It goes in the water. But to be fair, the 3 bites that I've had, I'm not going to miss them. They're like proper, like, oh, I'm on, pick me up. So that's brilliant. You know, 45 minutes to get my first bite, and I've had 3 fish in the next 20 minutes. So hopefully I can just work on that now and get the fish, you know, hopefully get the fish feeding and have a great day's fishing. Just took another one now. I had a cast. I left out at 9 minutes the last cast. Never had a bite. I've just had this bite after 7 minutes. So it's definitely going to be one of them days where you sort of leave it about 9 minutes and then wind back in. But it's nice fishing actually, even though it is very, very cold. I'm not sure what this is. It went steaming off when I hooked it. It probably is a skimmer, but it's proper banging. That's what's so nice about these rods. It feels like a massive roach, that. I'll be amazed if it is. If it is a roach, it's a big one. Nah, it's a high. I reckon that's a hybrid, that. Yeah, it is. That's beautiful, that. Because when I hooked it, absolutely steamed off. If that's a skimmer, he has got something wrong with him. Although, feeding in these conditions, they have got something wrong with him because it is absolutely bitterly cold. Yeah, look at that. That's a great big hybrid, that. I love them. Putting like 10, you know, 10, 15 pinkies in. Oh, yeah, look at that. Oh, I remember them. I used to catch a lot of them years ago on the pole here. Oh, what a fish to catch on a day like today. Look at that. Don't get better than that, does it? Absolutely stunning, immaculate Larford hybrid. Absolutely bitterly cold. Beautiful, that. Probably getting on for £2. So I'm just using my stopwatch. So important. So important on days like today. Just keeps you going. Stops you from sitting there and sitting there, thinking nothing's going to happen. And if you work a little bit harder, like I am, trying to suss your hook baits out, how much particles to put through. Make sure your hook length is completely clean. I hate them little bits of slime on. The amount of times I've cast out, even though when I'm catching loads and thinking, oh, I'll leave that bit of slime on, you don't get a bite and you've got to wind back in. But there's no, I've actually had 2 indications apart from the bites that I've had. But I'm putting a nice weight together because of the stamp of fish. if you can actually hear a banging noise in the background, there is an aerator going behind us, and it is making a bit of a clonking noise. So I apologise for that. You might not be able to pick it up, but believe me, it is there at the moment. So whilst that's just settling, get me a little stopwatch again. Reset that. It's going to be one of them days today, whether it just carry on with an odd bite, or hopefully we'll get a little burst of fish. You never know in these conditions. All I know is, in these conditions, when you're catching fish, it doesn't get better. Even though it's not hectic, it's just nice fishing. I must admit, I hooked that, and I thought, when I actually hooked it, I thought, oh, that's a nice bream. And it just, I actually took the back wind off because it actually bolted. And that's why, because it was a nice hybrid like that. But I think I've got five big skimmers now. Well, nearly bream, a small skimmer, and that big hybrid. So it's quite nice. And we've only been fishing for sort of two and a half hours now. So it's pretty good, really, considering, like, you know, the lakes have got a bit of ice on. The water's gone. The water's actually quite a nice colour, actually. It's not, it is, it's like a cleary brown. It's not gin clear. I quite like fishing lakes that have actually started clearing out in the winter. And the surface fishing can be absolutely fantastic when it goes clear. When they're really dirty, you do catch smaller fish, I think. But when you come to big lakes like this and the actual water clears out, that's when you can catch some good quality fish like I have today. And the only thing I'm really thinking now, if I was to have like maybe two or three, four casts, and I was leaving it out there sort of 8 to 10 minutes, and it went, is that's probably when I would unclip, take like a meter or meter to 2 meters off, and just have a cast past me kit. But at the moment, I just want to stick where I'm fishing, trying to get the fish to come to me. But there will maybe come a time, hopefully I haven't got to do that. I can just carry on getting the odd bite where I don't need to unclip and go past. But like I said, if I had like sort of two, you know, maybe four casts without a bite, then I might just unclip a meter to 2 meters, and then chuck past and see what happens. But I haven't got to that point yet. Hopefully I won't have to. Well, just looked at another one now. The last cast, or two casts ago, I caught a little 5-ounce skimmer. Then I sat out there for 8 minutes, never had a bite. And I've shucked that again. I've hooked this one after 3 minutes. And that just goes to show you. But what you've got to be careful of in this situation, I've done it before, when the fish aren't really sort of keen on feeding, is you can't sort of cast out either at 3 minutes. You can leave it, you've got to leave it a certain amount of time. It's hard to explain that, especially but at the moment, you've got to go really careful. It's like you've got to leave it there so long before you have another cast. But that's another great Larford bream, that. Look at him. I'm just looking, actually. He's just dumped on me. It looks like the black ground bait coming out. So that was on maggot. I actually had the last cast, I put a single maggot on, because I thought it might make a difference, but... No, I've wound back in after 8 minutes, put a maggot and pinky on, a few pinkies in the feeder, and it's gone straight, well, 3 minutes. But they're good quality, they're proper heavy then, they're proper winter skimmers. So, but it's lovely fishing. Not many bites, but they're quality. So let's do that again. So single maggot. 16 SFL hook. 011 power line up length. Just get a few pinkies in the feeder. Not a lot. Little squeeze as well. Not really squeezing it in that hard. It's literally just enough to get it out there and get it to the bottom. Nice little cast. It's the clip down. Just follow it a little bit like that. Watch that braid. You can see it stops it to the bottom. And because the fishing's quite difficult, I'm not really tight, just sort of tightening down to it and letting it, just taking your time. And why that's setting. Just get me stopwatch. But they're, apart from the little skimmer I've had, the three good skimmers, I think it's three or four now, big skimmers, they've all been quality bites. It's really, like, I've had one little indication before I've had a bite. The other ones have just, like, sat there and it's gone. But it's nice fishing. It's lovely on the little fine rod like an SL as well. Got a 20 gram feeder on. Little paternoster setup, which I've showed you lot, you know, on the Preston YouTube channel, how to do that little setup. I think it's a great setup. A foot length at the moment. So that's your hook. The hook from the bottom of the feeder is probably about 14 inches. And I've been to Larford over many, many years and fishing long hook lengths, and you'll find that on some commercials, even a big lake like Larford, fishing long hook lengths really just don't seem to work that well. And I always find about a foot is a great starting point. It really is. If I was getting indications and not catching, I could probably even go, actually, I remember a match here quite a few years ago and I was getting an odd little tiny indication and I went down to sort of like a 10 inch, or probably a bit less than that, probably about 8 inch hook length, and that made a big, big difference. But for me, about a foot on these sort of venues are sort of about the best starting point. Just tighten that down just a tiny little bit, like that. It's really interesting when you use a stopwatch, even for like bream and skimmers. It's like the carp fishing that we do during the winter time and the summer time. That little stopwatch can make a huge difference to your catch rate. But it's like if you get a bite after 3 or 4 minutes, you think, right, 5 minutes, I'll wind back in and cast out. And sometimes it slows your catch rate down. It's like you've got to leave it like 8 minutes. And that's what I'm trying to work out, the best time to wind back in to when I actually get a bite next cast. It's really, really interesting. And without that stopwatch, you would never know that. You know, sometimes when you're skimmer fishing, you don't need a stopwatch because you sort of in your head, you think, well, I should have had a bite now, and you wind back in and cast back out. But a day like today, when conditions are tough, but it's nice fishing, that's when a little stopwatch can make a huge difference. That was right on the limit of the time that I was going to leave it out. That was exactly 9 minutes. And I've been leaving it out there sort of 9 to 10. I was just about to wind that in. That rod absolutely doubled round. It is a soft rod, admittedly, but it absolutely, the tip belted round. I was actually I was thinking it was going to be a carp because obviously at Larford Specialty Lake, there is a rake of great big units in here. But with it being so cold. But I'm going to call this the last fish because I've had a mega winter day's fishing. And like I've always said, you know, when you come out on days like today, it's about getting that first bite and then trying to work out what you put through the feeder, your timings. Obviously, your hook baits are really important. What ground bait you use as well is really important. But that rod, absolutely fantastic playing fish like that in the winter on a rod like that. Look at that. That's a beautiful fish to finish off with that. That's been the average size, really, like 2 to 2.5 pound. I've only had that little high, well, that 2 pound hybrid and that little small skimmer, but they've all been like that. Look at them. They are really, really chunky as well. Real heavy. I bet that will go nearly 3 pound. Look at the width of it. Just getting back. So what I'm going to do is just run through exactly what we've done before I show you my fish. Just getting back. So basically, I've started, obviously got to me peg, found a little distance. Let's make sure he's all right. Found a nice distance, which I felt was probably about 25, 28 metres, something like that. I've not measured it. I've just cast out and thought with the conditions. You know, we've got a bit of ice on the water. It's really tough. You know, it's going to be a tough day. And I've put 6 feeder falls in, a bigger feeder than that. Probably like, that's like a 3 hole, if you like. I've probably put like a 5 hole feeder on. Chuck that out with hardly anything in it. Just a few dead maggots, a few pinkies. Chuck that out 6 times. A couple of them have hit the bottom. I've struck it out. And then the other ones, I've actually let it go down about sort of 3/4 depth and struck it out. So I'm trying to make a bit of an area. Change straight over to a small feeder because I am trying to get me first bite. And I've not changed that feed. I've not felt like putting a bigger feeder on today would make that much difference. It's about being patient, using your stopwatch. It took me 45 minutes to get my first bite. The difference is today, I really thought that we might catch some small skimmers and get the odd better one in between, but it's been quality fish today, which has been really, really nice. You know, sitting there, being nice and patient, using a stopwatch, you know, hook baits, simple setup, my normal setup where I've got an 8 pound sinking feeder mono with the paternos to set up on, and it's obviously loop to the braid. Nice 11 foot Supera SL, perfect for when you're fishing like this. You know, these rods I use all the time. A foot hook length, 011 power line, 16 SFL hook, and like I said, maggot and fluorid pinky. So I hope you've enjoyed it. I love this style of fishing. You know it's been a tough day. It's been very, very cold. But honestly, if you can come out to places such as Larford, if these fish switch on in the next couple of days, if it warms up a bit, you could catch a huge, huge weight by doing what I am today. So there you go. I hope you've enjoyed the video, and I'll show you what I've caught in a few seconds.